One of the key focuses of what we do is to make sure that the buildings are kept safe during an earthquake, and moreover that we make sure that the residents of those buildings are safe during an earthquake, and we protect both the residents and, if possible, the contents of the building as well. I was born in Greece and I grew up in Athens, and we get a lot of earthquakes in Athens. So this is something that happens very frequently. It is scary. Being in a building during an earthquake is scary. And I experienced the Athens earthquake of 1999, which was a substantially scary earthquake for all of us. We felt it as a violent motion. I still remember, with the lack of understanding that I had at the time, being in just about to get in high school, that everything around me was shaking. Maybe it is exaggerated in my head, but I remember watching one of the columns and a beam, and I remember watching how the angle between them would deform, and this didn't feel natural. So this is a seg table in the Oxford Structural Dynamics Lab. It is an electric seg table that we use to simulate earthquakes, where we have those two actuators that help us move the ground and simulate what would happen in a model like the one that we have here during an earthquake. This test has a scale version of a two-story building. And what we want to do is apply an earthquake on the ground level, which will induce a sinking into a building. A building is going to start moving. And specifically in this test, what we want to do is place sensors. These are the accelerometers that we place on different locations on the structure. And what we want to do is develop methods that will allow us to understand, by studying these acceleration signals from different floors, of what are the properties of the structure that we have here, and especially a very important question is of whether we can find out of whether we had damage during the earthquake on this structure. During an earthquake, you might think that hearing a building squeaking and those squeaking sounds is a bad thing, but it actually has some benefits. The key benefit is that this can be used as an alarm, alerting the residents that something bad is happening. And we want that. If we reach this situation where a building may collapse or is about to collapse, we want to make sure that the residents are aware of that. And in parallel, we also want to make sure, and this is how we design buildings, this is the philosophy with which we design buildings against earthquakes, we want to make sure that if we are in this inevitably bad situation where the building will collapse, that the time from the earthquake happening to collapse is as long as possible, so that we give enough time to the residents to safely evacuate the building and be somewhere on a safer place. Here we are looking at the hydraulic actuators. We use those actuators to apply forces directly on individual components. For example, here we would be testing a beam, and they help us allow large forces. And what we're trying to do here is that we're trying to apply the forces that this beam inside the building would experience during an earthquake. And this is through a technique that we are using here in Oxford in the Structural Dynamics Lab, pioneered from my colleagues, Martin Williams and Tony Blakewater. And in this technique that we call hybrid testing, real-time hybrid testing, we manage to apply forces on components on full scale. So if we had this beam, it would be part of a very large structure, and that very large structure would not fit within our lab. So rather than doing a full-scale experiment that would require a very large shake table, like the ones that we find in Japan, the E-Defense, and a very expensive system and overall test, we take a single component and we apply on that single component the forces that it would experience within the building during that earthquake. This helps us allow to have a realistic experiment, but under a reasonable budget and within the size constraints of our lab. The philosophy that we're using to protect buildings during earthquakes is very similar to the philosophy which is used to design modern-day vehicles and cars and protect them during an impact. So if we have a modern car, we do accept that during an impact, the car will not be remain intact. And we can think that for a car hitting another object with a very large velocity, there will be damage. And the priority of the philosophy with which we design modern cars is that we control this damage. We make sure that it forms in the front part of the car. And by the front part of the car being deformed, we make sure that we dissipate a lot of energy of the impact. And this keeps the cabin intact and the passengers of the car safe. We use the same philosophy to protect buildings during an earthquake, where we want to make sure that we have damage forming in secondary elements. For example, we want damage to form, if it is to form. We want it to form in windows, in walls. We don't want it to form on columns. And for example, a key part of our philosophy is that if we have a very large earthquake, a very strong earthquake, we want damage to form. If we have a column, which is a vertical element, and a beam, the horizontal element, we want our damage to form on the side of the beam and not the column. And by the damage forming on the beam, we dissipate energy and we keep the column safer. This philosophy is called the performance-based design philosophy. And it is very effective. So if there were no earthquake engineers, this would be a very difficult world to live in. And myself, at the age of 15, would live in a very scary world. Because the same earthquake that happened in 1999 in Athens would still have happened without earthquake engineers. And the buildings would not have been potentially properly designed to sustain that earthquake. And unfortunately, I would most likely not be alive today. And this is the situation for several people living in seismic areas, for which the role of an earthquake engineer is extremely important. I can't think of a world without earthquake engineers. As long as we have earthquakes, we are necessary.